Hello, good morning. This is Kalyani, lecturer in computer science. Today we are going to discuss the next topic in unit 3, relational model. The topic is relational algebra. Okay, so let's start, students. Relational algebra. What is relational algebra? In database theory, relational algebra is a theory that uses some algebraic structures. Actually, it's a purely have a mathematical background with a well-defined semantics for modeling data and defining queries on it. Okay, and this theory is introduced by E.F. Codd. The main application of this relational algebra is to provide a theoretical foundation for relational databases, particularly query languages for such databases which is SQL. Okay, relational algebra is a procedural query language. What is a procedural query language? So in this query language, where the user tells the system to carry out a set of operations to obtain the desired results. Okay, that means the user tells what data should be retrieved from the database and also how to retrieve it. That's why this relational algebra is called as procedural query language. Okay, and this relational algebra provides so many types of operators to perform operations on the relations. Okay, those operators can be either unary or binary. Those operators accept relations as their input and yield relations as their output. Okay, relational algebra is also performed recursively on the relation and intermediate results. Okay, while performing operations, it produces some of the results, intermediate results. Those also considered as relations. Okay, so let's learn about the relational algebra operators to perform operations. Okay, so the fundamental operations of relational algebra are classified as follows. Okay, so one is unary operators and operations, and second one is binary operations. Already you know that in unary operation or in unary operator, one relation will be participated, okay, in that particular operation, whereas in binary operation two relations will be participated, okay, two or more relations will be participated in the binary operation. Okay, so coming to the unary operations, there are three types of operations are there: selection, projection and rename. Okay, and just see some symbols have to be written here. Those are the operators, relational algebra operators. Okay, for selection it is called as sigma, and it projection pi, and rename rho symbol. Okay, and coming to the binary operations, there are so many binary operations are there: union, set difference, intersection and Cartesian product. And coming to inner join, in inner join there are two types of joins there: theta join and equi join. And coming to natural join, and coming to outer join. So in this outer join there are three types of joins there: left outer join, right outer join and full outer join. Okay, so in order to explain all these operations, let's take two tables. One is department and next one is employee. Okay, coming to the department table, we have three columns: department number, department name and location. Okay, and coming to the employee table, employee number, it has so many columns here: employee number, employee name, job, MGR means manager, and hire date means joining date, salary, commission and also department number. Actually those two tables are related with the common column department number. Okay, and those two tables have an association one to many between the department to employee relationship. Why? Because one department has so many employees and each employee is belongs to only one department. Okay. So first of all, selection operation, which is represented by the symbol sigma. Okay. This selection operation, first of all, in relational databases, what we have the data in the databases in the form of tables. That means the table is composed of rows and columns. Okay, rows are called as records, tuples, and columns are called as attributes. Okay, so this selection operation is used to selecting tuples, subset of tuples, according to the given selection condition. Okay, that means here the notation is there. Just see this notation. First of all, you have to write the select operator sigma. Okay, and next of all, you have to write the P. P is the preposition logic. Okay. So, and preposition logic, which may use the connectors like and or not. Okay, this sigma indicates stands for selection predicate. That means it's a selection condition. And R stands for the relation. That means which is the name of the table. Okay. And P is nothing but a preposition logic, which may use connectors like and or not, and relational operators like less than, greater than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, not equal to. Okay, like that. Okay, so the selection operation is nothing but row wise filtering. Okay, it can do the row wise filtering. Filtering of tuples from the database. Okay. And see this example. So, just we want to select tuples from EMP who are working in the department 10. Okay. So, what is the condition here? The department number equal to 10. Okay. So, it's a prepositional logic. By using the prepositional logic symbols, we used to write the condition here. Okay, it's a selection predicate. Okay, from which relation? EMP relation. So row indicates it's a selection predicate. Okay, so select the tuples from EMP relation. What it means, what this notation tells us, selection sigma indicates selection predicate. Okay, so select tuples from the EMP relation who are working in the department number 10. Okay, just see this exam output. There are three employees are there who are working in the 10th department. Okay, and coming to the second example, we want to select tuples from EMP where department number equal to 30 and also salary is greater than or equal to 2400. Okay, actually in department 30 so many employees are working there. Okay, so along with the department 30 condition, we have to check another condition here, the where the salary is greater than or equal to 2400. Okay, so by using the connectors, we used to connect two conditions here, and or not, like that, logical connectors, those are called. Okay, what is the selection predicate here? Department number equal to 30 and salary greater than or equal to 2400. Okay, so this notation tells us, selects the tuples from the EMP whose department number equal to 30 and also salary greater than or equal to 2400. Okay, only one employee existed in the employee table. Okay, named Blake. Okay. And what is the third one? Select tuples from the employee where job is salesman or working in the department 10. Okay. Just see this example. See this notation. Here the row symbol, row indicates the selection predicate. What is the condition here? The job equal to salesman or department number equal to 30. Okay, from employee relation. So we used to select the tuples from EMP where either working as a salesman or working in the department 10. Okay, there are nearly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 employees are there. Either working as a salesman or working in the department 10. Okay. Okay. And coming to the second operation, projection. Okay. So projection is considered as a column wise filtering, whereas projection operation can be considered as column wise filtering, whereas selection operation can be considered as row wise filtering. Okay. This is also works on a single relation or and it returns a vertical subset of attributes from the relation R. Okay, and eliminating duplicates also. Okay, so what is the notation here? Just to see this notation of this is pi symbol, pi A1 comma A2. So these are the attributes, whatever attributes you want to return, whatever attribute, subset of attributes you want to return from the table, you just written right here. Okay, A1, A2 and so on, AN, from which table, which relation R. Okay, so here the A1, A2, AN are the attribute names of the relation R. Okay, and in this projection, the duplicate rows are automatically eliminated. Okay, so finally, this is considered as a column-wise filtering. Just see this example. Okay, projects the column named as department number and D name from the relation DPT. Okay, so we want to retrieve two columns here. One is department number and D name from the relation departments. That's why we have to here we used to retrieve specified columns from the table. That's why we used the projection symbol pi. Okay, next of all, whatever attributes you have to retrieve from the table, you must write here. Okay, department number and D name from which relation? DEPT. Okay, this is the output for this example. Coming to union. Union. What is a union? Okay, so union means union between two tables or two relations means it contains all the tuples from both relations, and if there are any duplicate tuples, those are being eliminated from the output. Okay, for example, just see this notation. Okay, there are two relations, let us take two relations R and S. If you perform union operation between R and S, okay, it is indicated like this, union. Okay, R union S equal to, okay, tuples such that that tuple belongs to R or the tuple belongs to S. Okay, that means the tuples both in R and both in S. Okay, just it returns all the tuples of R and S. If there are any duplicates, those are being eliminated from the output. Okay. So, first of all, you must remember one thing. Before doing the union operation, set operations like union, intersection, minus, union and intersection, there must be union compatible tables are there. Okay. So, what is union compatible? What is the meaning of union compatible? Okay. For union operation to be valid, the following conditions must be hold. Okay, first of all, those relations must have the same number of attributes with the same domains. Okay, that means their names, their data type, their size should be equal, should be same. Okay, and the next property is if any duplicate rows are in two tables, those are being eliminated in the output. Okay, so only for union compatible tables we can perform union operation, otherwise we cannot. Okay, so let us take two relations here, the student 1 and student 2. The student 1 contains the student number, student name, CGPA and grade. There are three students are there. Another relation named with the student 2. In that there are three students' details are there. Okay, in that details one of the record 162003 record details will be record details repeated in both tables. Okay, just now we perform union operation. If you want to perform union operation between those two tables, the notation should be right like that. Okay, so you want to project some specified columns, that's why you have to write the pi symbol, and next of all you have to write the attribute name, student name, from which relation, student 1, and next of all you have to write the union symbol. Okay, next of all project student name from which relation, student 2. Okay, you should write like this. Okay, so this notation yields all the student names from student 1 relation and a student 2 relation. Okay, if there are any duplications, those being eliminated from the output. Okay, okay, actually Sita, it's a common record between the student 1 and student 2. Okay, that's why only one time it displayed only one time, duplication automatically, duplication being eliminated from the output. Okay, and coming to intersection, so an intersection is defined by the symbol. Okay, this is the intersection symbol. Okay, so what is an intersection? Already we know that it's defines a relation consisting of a set of tuples that are both in A and B, so which are common to the both relations A and B, and in this also A and B must be union compatible. Okay, just see this example notation: pi student name from the relation student 1. Okay, intersection pi student name from relation student 2. Okay, so it projects the name of the students which are common in student 1 and student 2. So what is the common name in student 1 and student 2? Sita. Okay, next, set difference. So in set difference, set difference means in this operation it returns the tuples which are present in first relation but not in the second relation, but those tuples are not in the second relation. R minus S means just it returns the all the tuples from R but not in the relation S. Okay, so just see this notation R minus S. So find all the tuples that are present in R but not in S. Okay, here also we are projecting a student name from student 1, that's why we have to write pi student name student 1. Okay, minus pi student name of student 2. Okay, so in student 1 there are some Sarada and Lata and Sita. Okay, but Sita also be in student 2, that's why it will be so eliminated from the output. Okay, here only the student names which are in the student 1 relation but not are in the student 2 relation. Okay, and coming to the Cartesian product. What is Cartesian product? This is the notation R cross S. Okay, that means the concatenation of every tuple in the relational R with the every tuple of relation S. Okay, that means each and every tuple in the relation R must be combined with each and every tuple in the relation R. For example, if R contains 4 rows, if S contains 3 rows, then resultant contains 4 into 3 12 rows. Okay, so this is the notation, just you observe R cross S equal to QT, such that Q belongs to R and T belongs to S. Okay. Just see this example. Okay. Projection, employee number, comma E name from the employee relation into, okay, projection, department number of department relation. Okay. That means in employee relation, the employee number and E name columns should be concatenated with each and every employee number and E name tuple should be concatenated with the department number column in the department table. Okay. Just see this example. Actually, we have in employee, we have 15 rows and in department, we have 4 rows. Okay. As a resultant, totally 15 into 4, 60 rows as returned as a result. Just see this. Okay. The employee number and E name, all 15 rows are to be concatenated with each and every department. Here the 10, 20 and 30 and next 40. Okay, totally 15 into 4 equal to 60 rows are returned as a result. And coming to the rename operation. Rename operation, it is also a unary operator and it is used to rename a relation or attributes of a relation or both. Okay, actually the results of relational algebra are also relations without any name. So the rename operation allows us to rename the output relation. Okay, and the rename operation is represented with small Greek notation rho. Okay, especially it is used to rename a relation or the attributes of relation or both. Okay, here there are three forms are there. First, just rho S of R. Okay, here in this S is the new relation name, R is the old relation name. Okay, just this notation indicates the R relation name renames with the S. Okay, and next row S of B1, B2 or Bn of R. Okay, and coming to this notation renames both the relation and its attributes. Here the B1, B2, Bn or so on are the new attribute names in the order they are existing in the table R. Okay. So, third notation row B1, B2, so on Bn of R. This renames the attribute only. Okay. So, if you want to change the renames the relation only, relation name only, then you must follow the first notation. Or you want to change the both relation and its attributes, you have to follow the second notation. If you want to change the renames the attribute only, you have to follow the third notation. Okay. Coming to the join operation. What is join operation? Okay. Join operation is very, 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 very important feature in the relational databases. Okay. So, when you want the data from more than one table in the when you want to retrieve the data from more than one table in the databases, is required, a join condition is used. Join can be done by using common values in the common column in both tables. Okay, okay. So if you want to perform a join, normally those tables are to be related, okay, and also have a common column. Based on the common column values in both tables, rows are to be combined or rows are to be joined together from two tables, okay. And the join operation is denoted by this symbol. Okay. And there are so many types of joins are there. First one is inner join. In inner join, there are two types of joins, theta join and equi join. And second one is natural join. And third one is outer join. In outer join, again, left outer join, right outer join and full outer join. There are three types of joins are there. Okay. So let's discuss the types of joins. Okay, okay. First of all, inner join. What is inner join? Okay, so normally inner join is only those tuples that satisfies the matching criteria are included. The rest are excluded. Okay, that means only the rows which are having the which are satisfies the matching criteria, that means based on the common values in the common columns, only those rows are to be included in that output. Other tuples are excluded. Okay, so let's study various types of inner joins are there. Okay, first of all, theta join. A general case of join operation is known as theta join. Okay, it's a denoted by the symbol. This is the theta join symbol. Actually, theta join combines or merges row from two tables depending upon the theta condition. Okay, here the theta is nothing but here theta condition. That's why the notation we have to write like that. A, okay, join symbol and theta. Theta is nothing but condition and B. Okay, depending upon the condition, those tuples are to be joined from two tables. Okay, and this theta condition can be made up of any comparison operators like less than, greater than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to also. And those are used in the selection criteria. Okay, what is the selection criteria? Whatever condition you have written in this. Okay, in that condition, you used all these comparison operators. Okay, okay. And when you are... when we require a theta join, okay, what is the purpose of theta join? The next question is, okay, if you want to combine the tuples from two or more relations where the condition is not simply the equality of the shared attributes, okay, then it is very convenient to have more general form of join operator, so which is known as theta join, okay. Normally, when you want to join two tables, we used to perform equal to condition between those shared attributes or common attributes. So, if you want to write other than equality of shared attributes, then we are using join operator theta join. Okay, this is called as a theta join. Okay, so just see this diagram, see this tables. Okay, there are three tables: employee table and department table and salary table. Of course, we know that in employee table and department table we have a common column department number, but in employee table and salary table there are no common attribute between those two tables. Okay, here the salary table represents a grade and low sal and a high sal. Okay, okay, so let's see this example. Okay, this is for theta join. In this theta join, what we are writing here, okay, this is the theta condition. This is the condition. This condition represents theta. Okay, what we are writing here, the projecting E name and sal from EMP and also projecting grade attribute from the sal grade table. Okay, so what is the condition here? Where the employee salary must be greater than, okay, high sal attribute, high sal attribute values in the sal grade table. Okay, that means here you want to retrieve the employee name and salary and grade from the sal grade table, whose salary is greater than high salary in the sal grade table. Okay, just see this tables once. Here the sal grade table, we have three columns: grade and low sal and high sal. Okay, depending upon the range between the low sal and high sal, here the grades are provided 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I want to retrieve the employee number, employee name and grade from the sal grade table whose salary is greater than high salary of the sal grade table. Okay, okay, so this is the example, this is the output for that. And coming to equi join, so equi join is same as theta join. Okay, but the comparison operator in the join condition is equality operator. Okay, so theta join uses equal operator. Okay, if the join uses the equal operator in the join condition, that type of join is called as equi join. Normally equi join combines the tuples from two or more tables based on common values in the common column. Okay, just see this example. So in condition, okay, here the condition, theta condition, in this condition what we are using, equality operator here, equal operator. Okay, when you are using equal operator in the join condition, that type of condition, that type of join is called as equi join. Okay, here the projecting some names like employee number, e name, job, MGR, hire date, salary, column and department number. And coming to here, the projecting some other columns from department, department number and d name, comma location, whose employee department number is equal to department number in the department table. Just see this. Okay, here the department number, this department number from EMP table and this department number column from department number. Okay, just see this diagram, see this output. Okay, what we have retrieved here, the department 10. Okay, so what is the 10th department? 10th accounting, New York. Okay, for the department 10, only 10th department details are to be added together from the together to the employee details. Okay, okay, so just it retrieves the employee details along with his department details also. Coming to the natural join. So natural join, so natural join is also binary operator, which will be written as like this. Okay, so what is the difference between the natural join and equi join? Actually both are same, but in natural join no need to specify the join condition explicitly, and also duplicate attributes are eliminated from the result. Okay, so just see this previous output of equi join. In this equi join, just we written here the employee department number and department number. Okay, so department number, actually it's a duplicate column, but two times it will be repeated. Okay, with same value. Okay, whereas in natural join, no need to specify the condition explicitly. Based on the common values in the common column, both rows are to be combined together naturally. Okay, so no need to use the specify the join condition explicitly, and also duplicate attributes can be eliminated from the result. Just you observe here the natural join, Okay, in this natural join here, no condition will be specified here. Okay, so the same example without the join condition. Okay, but what we have in the output, the only department number column. Actually, department number column is a duplicate common column between the employee table and department table. That's why duplicate column will be eliminated from the output. Okay, so that's why department number is not repeated here. Only duplicate column being eliminated from this output. Okay. So coming to the outer joins. So what are the outer joins? Actually, in natural join and equi join and inner join, only based on the matching criteria, those tuples which satisfies the matching criteria are to be returned in the results. Only those tuples returned as a result in the output. Okay, so remaining rows are to be excluded from the output. Okay, only matched rows are included in the result. Unmatched rows are excluded from the result. So in order to retrieve along unmatched rows along with matched rows in the output, we used outer joins. Okay, there are three types of outer joins are there. First one is right outer join, and next one is right left outer join, and third one is full outer join. Okay. Just you observe these tables, employee table and department table. Okay, here 15 employees are there. Okay, but one employee not assigned to any department yet. Okay, and also just you observe there are four records. Okay, for 40th department is there in for 40th department. Is there is existing in department table, but no employee is assigned to this department. Okay, so that's why it's an unmatched row, and this is also unmatched row. Okay, for 40th department there are no employees in the employee table, and for Sairam there is no department. Okay, department is not assigned yet for this employee, to this employee. Okay. Okay. Coming to the right outer join, the notation is written like this. Okay, A right outer join B. Okay. So in right outer join, operation all allows keeping all the tuples in the right relation. However, if there are no matching tuple found in the left relation, then the attributes of the left relation in the join result are filled with null values. What it means? Okay. So just observe this diagram. Projection, some columns from the employee table, and projection some columns from the department table. Okay, here we are performing right outer join operation between those two tables. So what is the right side table here? The department table. Okay, so already we know that for 40th department there is no one is assigned to 40th department. So no matching row from the left side table employee. That's why those are to be filled with null values. Okay, just you observe last record, you observe. Okay, right outer join, it returns both matching rows and as well as unmatched rows from the left right relation. Okay, so if there is no matching tuple is found in the left relation, then the attributes of the left relation are filled with the null values. Okay, that's why for 40th record, okay, from the right table department, okay, we retrieved an unmatched row 40 operations Boston record, but there is no matching tuple in the right side table EMP. That's why those are filled with the null values. Just you observe carefully. And coming to left outer join. Left outer join notation A, left outer join B. Just you observe these symbols first. Okay, so in left outer join, operation allows keeping all the tuples in the left relation. However, if there are no matching tuple found in the right relation, then the attributes of the right relation in the join results are filled with null values. Okay. So, what is the left side table? EMP table. What is the right side table? Department table. So, in left side table, one record, one employee A existing, 7555 with name Sairam. Okay, he is not assigned to any department yet. Okay, that's why there are no corresponding matching row from the right side table. Okay, that's why those attributes are to be filled with null values. Okay, just see this diagram very carefully. Okay, and coming to the full outer join. So, full outer join means it keeps all the tuples in both left and right relations. Okay. So, when no matching tuples are found, padding them with null values as needed. Okay. Just you observe. Just the full outer join keeps all the tuples from both left and right relations. Okay. Just you observe. Here the Sairam record. Okay, for Sairam, there are no department. That's why the department number, department name and location are to be filled with null values. And as well as from department 40, for 40th department, there are no employee. Okay, that's why all the employee details are to be padded with null values. Okay, this is known as full outer join. And coming to the semi-join. Okay, what is semi-join? Actually, semi-join is known as off of the join. That means it returns the rows from first table where one or more matches are found in the second table. Okay, semi-join matches the rows of two relations and only show the matching rows of relation whose name mentioned to the left side of semi-join operator. Okay, this is the semi-join operator. Left side of the semi-join operator. Okay. So, match shows the matching rows of the relation whose name is mentioned to the left of the semi-join operator. Okay. This is also called as off of the join. Just it returns the rows from the first table only. Okay. Just see this diagram. It's a semi-join. What is the left side of the table? Employee. That's why only employee number and employee name. Okay. D name and location. So, this is the condition here. Okay, projection, employee number, E name, D name and location. So all these attributes, so there are two attributes from the first left side table and two attributes from the right side table. Okay, so it's an semi-join. Semi-join means it's off of the join. It shows only the attributes from the left side table. Okay, so that's why it shows the employee number and E name as a rename column values as a result. Okay. It's a semi-join. So, coming to the advantages of relational algebra. So, relational algebra has a solid mathematical background. Okay. So, it's a very, very important. Why? Because anyone have a strong mathematical background. So, that's why it's very easy to learn. Okay. And it is also basis for many interesting developments and theorems. Why? Because it has a strong mathematical background. That's why it's a basis for many interesting developments and theorems also. Okay. Relational algebra is a high level language. Okay, which takes in terms of properties and set of tuples and not in terms of a for loop. Okay, it's a high level language, that means easy to understand. And also
query optimizer. Okay, when you have two expressions for the same operation, and if the expressions are proved to be equivalent, then the query optimizer can automatically substitute the more efficient form. Okay, so and that means the relational algebra is used to find a query optimizer. Okay, how the query is executed in its better way. Okay, it's only possible by using the relational algebra. Why? Because the relational algebra has a solid mathematical background. It's a first advantage, first and most advantage. And coming to disadvantages, of course, where there are some advantages, there must be some limitations also. Okay, and the relational algebra cannot do arithmetic. Okay, so in relational algebra, we use to project and select the tuples or columns from the relations. Okay, it cannot perform any arithmetic operations, and also the relational algebra cannot sort out the results in various formats, and either in increasing order or either in decreasing order or alphabetical order like that. Okay, and it does not perform any aggregate functions. Okay, so aggregate functions means the functions which are performed on the group of values in the column, like maximum, minimum, sum, average, like that. So those aggregate operations cannot be performed in the relational algebra, and the relational algebra cannot modify the database also. Of course, if you want to increase a salary of employees by 10%, it cannot be done in the relational algebra. Okay, and coming to the FAQ, frequently asked questions. What is relational algebra? Explain relational algebra operators. Okay, this is for 10 marks question. This is very, very, very important question. And the second one is, what are the advantages and advantages and limitations of relational algebra? Okay, I think students, I think you can understand this topic. Just watch thoroughly this YouTube and follow those notations and examples carefully, and write down the running notes also. If you have any doubts, just approach me to clarify your doubts. Okay, thank you.